Hey guys, Andrew here, and welcome back to another episode of Edith Finch. When we last left off, we had found out about a couple of more dead people, visited a cemetery, and we're standing in front of a dead baby's crib. So let's check out about Gregory the dead baby. Just medical records? Oh, a divorce contract? Divorce to Sam? What? Hey, Carly and Sam Finch. Okay.
Dear Kay, do you remember the way Gregory used to laugh when he thought he was alone? Like something funny was happening, but only he could see it.
Great.
I think he saw things the rest of us don't.
All right. I guess being a baby is fun. Oh, God. Oh. My toy. Oh, wait. I'm the frog now?
Gregory, it's time to... Hold on, sweetie.
Okay, it's... Hello? All right. Goodbye, Mom.
Sam, I told you I don't want to talk right now.
I wonder what he saw.
What?
What his world was like.
What?
He reminded me so much of Calvin. In his imagination.
What?
Whatever it was, he saw. It sure made him happy.
Oh my God, what is happening? I'm so confused. All right, get out of here, Gregory. No one likes you. Whoa!
I know how silly it sounds.
What?
Gregory?
I know you did everything you could. Maybe if I hadn't called that night.
What? What? Why did you do that?
Hold on, I don't want Gregory to hear this.
I wish he could have told us about the world he saw.
You don't hear the bath?
There's so much I don't understand.
Oh my God!
About Gregory.
What the fuck? What is happening? Am I playing as a drowning baby?
But I know what happened wasn't your fault.
Oh my God. Is he? He's dead!
I want you to be happy too. Good luck, Kay. Love, Sam.
Oh my God! Gonna draw a doodle of a dead baby? Great. Why? Just why? All right, well, tell me more about you, Gus.
poem for Gus, who always said the wedding was a bad idea. Our father never hit us kids, at least not very hard, before the day my brother said with teenage disregard that he'd be dead before he'd see a wedding in our yard. My father made him come, of course, but Gus stood far apart, just flew his kite and bottled up the storm inside his heart.
Okay. Woo! Very pretty.
But though he'd never met her, we don't need a stepmom or the words that.
Did this on the shore? Oh, God. Is that supposed to happen? Okay. Is there anything else I'm supposed to do? Or... What? What do you want from me? I'm just a dumb kid with a kite. Okay.
When the time for photos came, Dad ordered him to
come here.
But Gus declined, and as a sign, held up his middle finger.
Whoosh. Wow, I like this kid already, though. Good kid.
Picked up, and panicked geese appeared and quickly went. But all the humans did that day was go inside the tent.
Bah! Take that, family! I spite you with my flying device. I am a god! Oh my god, okay.
Came down in buckets then, but no one seemed to free. That nature might destroy the tent of death completely.
What? I need more stuff? Give me more stuff!
The thunder sounded much too close and full of angry howls. But all my father said was, make the music louder.
What? Excuse me?
I wish that I could truly say I thought about you on that day. Out there on the beach alone, just you, the wind, the sea, and foam. But I didn't. Until we found you.
Oh. Wow.
She never talked about him, but Mom told me once if I was a boy, they were going to name me Gus.
What? That doesn't make any sense, because you had, she had two boys, and she named them Lewis and Milton. Why the fuck, if she had another boy, would she name it Gus? What? She wouldn't name it, like, Sam Jr., or, like, Sven Jr., because you're named after your grandma. Why wouldn't you just name one of them after the fucking grandpa? What kind of statement is that? Also, wow, you died on your dad's wedding. Way to be a jerkhole. God. Even I didn't die on my dad's wedding. And I'm an asshole. Alright, raise flag, 7:30 a.m., breakfast, 8 a.m., quiet time, 11 p.m. Duties. Dawn, sweep trash. Gus, mop, mow yard. Greg, be a baby. I don't know about that one. That one's a little rough. I mean, he's less than a year old. Routine, jump rope, 100 times. Jumping jacks, 150 times. Push-ups, 100 times. Crunches, 100 times. Under the mailbox and back. I mean, at least...
My mom moved up to the loft after her brothers died.
Okay.
At the time, it was as far away as she could get.
She couldn't go in anybody else's room? Oh, wow, this is not too bad of a place. It's kind of nice. I mean, you put a baby in a place that has no damn insulation on the roof. Seriously, guys. Maybe the drowning wasn't the reason that the baby died. It might have died from freaking hypothermia. What is wrong with you people? Build a house correctly. You're killing me, Smalls. What is this place?
Religion was another thing my mom never talked about, but I think it helped her a lot after her dad died.
I mean, I guess whatever, to each their own. Okay.
She spent a summer building houses in Calcutta, where she met my dad, Sanjay.
Oh, that's Sanjay. Sanjay? Hello. Orcas Island High School. Oh, Don Finch Senior. Thank you for building us houses so we don't die. Wow, I mean, building houses is kind of cool, I guess. 10 ways to teach critical thinking for the homeschool student and teacher. Copy passport, fly to India, pack on the last day? It's very lazy of you. Very, what's the word I'm looking for? Procrastination. You got a procrastination problem.
After graduation, and got a job teaching English. Lewis was born a year later.
How romantic. Moved to where her lover was.
When my dad died, I don't think Mom knew where else to go. I'm sure Edie was happy to have her back.
I mean, probably? She was literally the only living person in this house. Like, oh my god, this fucking woman has been alive through it all. She has seen death. Like, ravage her family, all the while wondering why it hasn't taken her yet. She sat there wishing it was her instead, but alas, death decided no. It was not your time. You would suffer first.
And to see kids in the house again.
I mean, it's a cute little garden, though. Does it get a lot of sun up here? Oh, I guess not, because you put a tarp above it. So I guess they're not plants that need a lot of sun. I mean, I see you got, you know, mint, thyme, sage, and basil, which, all right. I mean, I don't know about this drip system. First of all, there's no water going to the basil. Second of all, there's, like, no, it's not even a drip system. It's just a straight fucking hose system. So it's just, like, water's just gonna sprout out. I mean, it's an interesting concept, just a bunch of steel pipes and whatnot, but this is not very practical. Any case, let's move on. I don't need to dish out my gardening tips.
Dad had to get a little bigger, but Edie was used to that.
She was? Who was building this house a little bigger, you know? That's the real question. Who was building this damn house bigger?
And for a while, things were good. Almost normal.
Wow, your mom homeschooled you? Okay. I mean, you had enough freaking books! Are these actually alphabetically ordered? No, they're not! There's fucking books that start with D in the VZ section! God, you can't even organize your stupid books! Also, you have a book You have a book in this classroom, which I assume is for children, called Dungeon Master. Are you teaching your kids how to play D&D in first grade? Kidding with science. It's okay. Biology. Okay. I mean, these make sense. Cheat Code Kings, Volume 3. What? How? Masters of Game Design? I guess? If your kid's gonna be a game did you do college here too?
But it didn't last.
This is silly. Oh, we did a report on Odin Finch. The curse. The curse. Myth, history. Oh, good. Someone used a Wikipedia article to find out about their family. Is that what, Edie does all day? Just updates the Wikipedia article. Oh, well, my son just died. I guess I better update that page and tell him that another Finch is dead. Wow, this is classification of living things. I feel like you just kind of started losing track. It's like a shitty design right there. Oh, yeah, that fits. Okay, yeah. Family? Okay. All right. Species is a little out there. And variety is just not even fitting. Okay. So we have a school to teach and to learn. 7 ways to create a fulfilling classroom. With a cross? Don't teach your children religion, people. That's child abuse. You can't teach them shit like that. They don't understand the basic concepts of morality, right or wrong, and telling them it too early could cause them to become terrified of the unknown or making mistakes, which could lead to anxiety and possibly acting out and doing worse things than they would have been if you didn't teach them religion at a young age. Keep that shit to yourself. If they want to learn about God, they'll do it as an adult. Also, wow, you have a laptop. This is pretty fancy. When did you have kids? When were you born? 1999? So you would have been I guess it would have been 2000-something. You died in 2003. You're pregnant. Are you, in college? 2016, 1999. What is that? No, you're 17. Oh, that's right, you said you were 17 in the beginning. You're 17 and pregnant? Come on, man. Did your mom not teach you good ethics in school? With God everywhere? How did you get pregnant before marriage? Oh no, the rant I said earlier was true. Oh God. Scientific method. Observation, question, research, hypothesis, experiment, data, conclusion. Okay. Great job.
Beginning of the end was Milton's 10th birthday, when Edie gave him a castle.
Gave him? Did she build it herself? Oh, I can't get in there.
After Milton disappeared, the only thing he left behind was a room full of paintings.
It's like a lighthouse? Not really a castle. It's kind of it's more like a lighthouse. Oh. I'm glad you sealed the door, Mom, but you didn't seal the window, Mom. Also, why is there an opening on the outside of the window to get in? That's kind of weird. I wouldn't like that. Also, I'd be super sketched out to sleep up here. It still doesn't seem very structurally sound, honestly. Oh, dang, he's gonna be an architect. Look at that. That's really fucking cool. So he was gonna take up, Seven's place. He was gonna be a builder and just build cool things. Or not, maybe not a builder, but he was an architect. I mean, he wanted to create.
I think Edie was happy to finally have another painter in the family.
Hey, wait a second. Is this the creator of that Black Swan game where you throw paint everywhere? Because that looks familiar. What? Oh. Wow. This is really cool. That's really cool, too. I like this kid. He's got some promise in him. He likes to paint. He's got this thing about crowns and mustaches for some weird reason. I don't know who built him this castle. Also, it goes higher. Oh. Oh, God. All right. Well, let's find out about Milton.
Milton Finch in The Magic Paintbrush.
Oh, you know what? Actually, how many people we got left? Milton, Lewis, Dawn. Okay, yeah, that's fine. Let's learn about Milton. What? What? Oh. Thank you. Oh.
I was 4 when Milton disappeared.
Wait. Excuse me? Why are you gonna draw him like a cartoon character, but you're gonna draw literally everyone fucking else like their regular selves? I'm a little confused about your decision here. You want people to remember Milton as a cartoon character? Okay, I'll let you go on with that. What is wrong with you? There's a picture of him right there. Come on. Madness. His family is full of madness. All right, well, let's get out of here.
Mom spent months searching for my brother. Then she sealed the doors.
I'm sorry to hear that.
Whatever Milton had found in the house, Mom didn't want it getting out.
I mean, he found it, though, so props to him.
Mom definitely blamed Edie, but I think Lewis blamed himself. After he graduated, he just spent more and more time in his room. Until Mom got him a job at the cannery.
No, that was nice of her.
Everyone always told me to stay out of Lewis's room. Except Lewis.
I can see why. Legalize marijuana. Legalize that marijuana. The kids are all raving about it. Alright. Up and over. This is literally on top of a boat. Come on now. Now you're getting lazy. You're literally running out of material. You're just building a house out of the scraps you've got lying around. Oh. Whoop. I mean, it's kind of cool, though. You know? Having half of your room a boat.
Lewis's room smelled very, very familiar. That part of him lived on.
What? The weed? Yeah, the weed didn't die with him. Like, I don't know what that's supposed to mean. What was that statement? Alright, cool. So he had a Wonderland Turbo. Yes, this is by the same person, apparently, who made the Black Swan games. Or whatever those are called. Are those called Black Swans? Maybe they're called Black Swans. Because that is the exact same logo from that game.
Lewis and I spent a lot of time playing games together, but he was surprisingly bad at them. He died a lot.
How ironic! He died a lot, you say? Almost like he died in real life. No, that's just mean. But really, he died in real life. It's probably from weed. Don't do drugs, kids. See, when you try to legalize things, it gets you killed. If he just smoked weed and didn't try to legalize it, probably would have survived a lot longer. Don't try to legalize things. Let everything stay illegal and just do it anyways. Oh, come on, man. What is that supposed to be what weed looks like? It's not what weed looks like. It doesn't look like leaves. Also, that pipe is low, really low quality pipe. And he has a hookah as well? Guess he just felt like not smoking weed sometimes, and just felt like having hookah? What is that? Theodore's quality cigars? He smoked cigars as well. Wow, he's just pumping everything into his lungs. Live life to the fullest, I guess, man. Live life to the fullest. Alright, well, before we find out more about Lewis, I'm gonna go ahead and say thank you guys for watching. If you like what you see, go ahead and click subscribe. Otherwise, leave a comment in the comment section below to remember the worst Edith Finch player you've ever seen before. As always, thank you guys for watching. See you guys next time, and